Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to our channel. After an incredible month and a half here in Malaysia, it is finally time to leave this beautiful country and go to our next destination, Japan.
I don't understand what anything means.
Nothing. Not a clue what anything is.
Japan is actually a country that we did not expect to explore this year. So as we make our way there, we'll share with you the story of what's been going on behind the scenes that made us change our minds.
Oh, it's so cute.
We have entered a Japanese electronics store. So much signage I don't recognize.
Touch it.
Oh, it's hot.
How weird is that? They're warm.
The guy bowed so hard, I swear his forehead touched the table.
Japan! Alright, so the travel plan for today is there are two flights that we're taking. The first one is Kuala Lumpur to Manila, which is kind of cool. Back to the Philippines for a half a second. And then we hop on the second flight, Manila to Haneda, Tokyo. Reasons why Japan was never on the list for like our around the world travels. The first is probably the most obvious, which is the cost.
Japan is pretty pricey.
Yeah, during our travels, if you've been watching our vlogs for a while, we travel pretty like backpacker style. We're keeping track of how much money we spent. And there's also a second reason that Japan was never on our list.
And that's because we've both been there before.
Well, I haven't really been there before. So on our way back from our honeymoon in 2014, we stopped in Tokyo for like a 12-hour layover. We went to like Shibuya Crossing and a cat cafe or something.
It was like a really crazy long layover that just like worked out well so that we can like leave the airport, go explore Tokyo for just a little bit, and then get back to catch our flight back home to Canada.
Yeah,
that was a little bit. Nicole did.
Like a tiny, tiny bit. What we could do in like 12-hour layover, you know? And then a couple years after that, Nico went back.
Yeah, I went back for a proper Japan trip with me and a buddy back home from Canada. And we went to visit my brother, who was living in Japan at the time. So we hung out with him for a little bit, went around Tokyo, we did Kyoto and Osaka, and went as far down as Nagasaki and Okinawa, and even further than that. And we even actually had the opportunity to go and climb Mount Fuji, which honestly, I think is one of my favorite memories of Japan.
Yeah.
But despite all those reasons not to go to Japan, we actually had to change our minds because something happened about 8 months ago that's really changed our connection to Japan and Japanese people. Before we dive into exactly what that special connection is, we're gonna go catch our flight and we will see you guys in Japan.
Thank you.
We care for your safety. Please take your assigned seats as soon as possible to facilitate our departure. Please keep your seatbelts fastened whenever you are seated. Thank you for flying Philippine Airlines. Salamat sa Filipino. Mabuhay. In a few minutes, we shall begin our initial descent towards our destination, Tokyo Haneda. We hope that you enjoy your stay in Haneda and to the rest of your other destinations.
Officially made it!
We're in Japan! Oh my god.
Welcome to Japan, everybody.
I feel like I'm like in shock a little. Like I just didn't expect to be here, so I'm like, we're in Japan? Tokyo!
When we came in, like when the plane like parked where it parks at the airport here, the guy that was like waving people to come in, like the little flag, the planes come in. Right when the plane stopped, he like stopped and took a bow.
To the plane?
To the plane. I'm like, I don't think anybody saw him except for me, who was watching. It's like military precision bowing right when the plane stopped.
Am I gonna have to learn how to bow properly?
Maybe.
All right, we have made it successfully through all of the securities, all the checkpoints, which means that we are officially on Tokyo soil. We are in Japan.
It feels amazing, we are exhausted because it's 12:45 a.m.
Yeah, so the next thing we gotta do is try and figure out how to get to our hotel. And the only trouble we might have is that the hotel, we're not totally sure that they're open this late. So we just really cross our fingers that they are because we've got no other way of getting a hold of them. So this will be an adventure.
Haneda です。
like right there. Also, it's getting cold.
Yep.
Taxi drivers are wearing suits. This is a fancy taxi ride.
Okay, we got an Uber. The license plate is this thing, that thing, and then 310, and then something like that, and then a 5.
Perfect. It says they're here. I don't know, I don't see you, buddy.
Okay. Hello.
Perfect. Wow.
So we will go to the Kawasaki.
So I feel a little bit like we might accidentally ordered a limo. Like what is this?
It's super nice.
This is very nice. Thank you so much.
Have a good night. Hey, really quickly, that was an amazing cab ride. That's probably like, one of the coolest cab rides I had.
I honestly felt like I was like sitting in like business class on an airplane for the first time.
Yeah.
It was magic.
The interior was spotless and so comfortable. And like the taxi driver guy, he was like in a full suit. He was wearing like white gloves.
Yeah, white gloves, and he's like moving the shifter with his white glove. Yeah. I'm like, what? Where are we?
What? Hello. Hello.
Hello.
We're here to check in. Thank you.
Success. The hotel's open. Oh, it's so warm in here.
Oh, it's so...
Hello.
Start reading passport.
I've never checked in for a hotel.
And your QR code.
Electronically. How many receipts do I need? Is it good?
Please take your car key. Room key is being issued.
That is so cool.
Oh, do we each get them?
Please take your car key.
Nico can have one too. So we've been told we can take anything from here for free. There's like hair wax, body sponge, all different kinds of lotion, like soap for the tub. Just take what you need. Razors, hair elastics.
Cool. Touch the room card here.
You guys, I love Japan.
So like, everything's futuristic.
Like
and automatic.
And the doors don't close.
Except the elevator.
Like I don't understand. It's like I could rent for free a curling iron if I want from this hotel.
Just right there. Usually we have to like make multiple phone calls for Airbnbs to just get like an extra pot or
yeah,
something.
Yeah, like, for sometimes. Like we can't cook everything. We need a pot. Maybe it'll show up a week later.
I think it's safe to say that we're very impressed so far.
So impressed.
Wow.
So I should explain, we're only staying in this hotel for one night because we got into Haneda and it's like the middle of the night and the trains don't run and stuff, right? So we're only staying here one night and then tomorrow we make our way all the way into Tokyo proper city and like stay in the place that we're gonna stay for the next week or so while we explore.
And tomorrow is also when we will continue our story, so we'll see you guys in the morning.
Yeah, we need to get some sleep. So we did not sleep enough. It's only been like 5 hours, but we slept so well, at least for those 5 hours. First breakfast in Japan. Mmm. It's like an inverted cheese and ham sandwich. The cheese is melted on the top. Okay, while we have our coffee, let's tell you guys a little bit more about the story of why Japan is a place that we're visiting even though we really never thought we were gonna come here. Like Miko said, a couple of years ago, he came to Japan to visit his brother. So his brother lived and worked here for like 3 years. While he was here, he met a Japanese woman and they have since gotten married.
And ever since they got married, they started living in Canada. 8 months ago, they had a baby girl. It's a niece that we haven't yet met.
Yeah.
And they're actually taking the opportunity this year to take their daughter to Japan.
For
the first time so that she can meet the rest of her family. That means that my brother and his family are coming to Japan and we happen to be in the same area of the world, so...
We decided to come too. Of course, not only do we get to meet our baby niece and catch up with Miko's brother and his wife, but we also get to hang out and meet our sister-in-law's Japanese family, which is like an opportunity that I just think wouldn't come very often in our lives. So we jumped on it.
But we have a small problem because the family really doesn't live anywhere near Tokyo. So we have a long way to go and we've got kind of a wicked plan of how we're gonna get there while at the same time exploring Japan. Yeah. But we're gonna finish our coffee,
check out of this hotel, make our way to our new hotel, and we'll tell you more about it when we get there.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Japan! Okay.
It's also so cold.
This temperature is amazing. Like, we don't need a sweater in a minute, but this feels so good.
We've been in hot places for a long time, and I know that seems like a full-time traveler, like, problems, but it's nice to, like, take a little bit of a break.
It's just
go somewhere
humidity.
A little bit cooler.
It's the humidity.
Yeah, the dryness here
I'm
is
not
so nice.
I'm not already.
We have stumbled upon a random walking street. We're looking to find, like, we're walking around to find SIM cards.
We took a wrong turn.
We took a wrong turn, and then all of a sudden we're in this amazing street. There's so many things going on.
It's like a pedestrian street.
Yeah, it's like 11 in the morning. I'm just like, I feel overwhelmed with how much signage and like people and like, but like just how organized and
clean. It's really cool.
I don't know about you, but I'm getting way more excited than I thought I'd ever be. Be exploring Japan again for me, and really a first time for you.
Yeah, first time for me. 12 hours doesn't count. Sounds good. Don't know what she's saying.
I don't understand what anything means.
Nothing. Not a clue what anything is. Not a clue. So since beginning our research on trying to get a SIM card in Japan, we have learned that Japan is just like so far in the future that our phones are really dated. They're like 3 or 4 years old. That everyone here gets eSIMs, but we don't have eSIM capability on our phone. And I like feel like we're living in the Stone Age.
Yeah.
Because trying to get a physical SIM in Tokyo is very hard. I think we're gonna figure it out, but like, it is actually so hard that I feel like I'm with the dinosaurs right now. Which camera store is it?
Yodobashi.
We have entered a Japanese electronics store. So much signage I don't recognize. It is wild.
There's so much writing in this store, and there's like a lot of music. I feel pretty overwhelmed, I won't lie.
I also just want to add that I feel like this is a level of sensory overload and stimulus that we haven't felt in a long time. I feel like normally when we're just like overwhelmed by situations because there's so many like
people
honking and people and
smells.
Like dirt and smells and just senses are going wild. But here it's like different.
It's like it's bright almost lights like, and lots of color.
It's like I feel like more excitement towards it because I'm like, I feel like a kid at a candy shop looking at all the shiny things. I was just telling Nicole that like I just can't believe how like service-oriented people here working are in Japan. That like I said, I wouldn't be surprised if the once we buy our SIM cards, the person, the cashier would bow to us like as a sign of thank you. And like as soon as I bought the SIM cards, the guy bowed so hard. I swear his forehead touched the table. Blown away by like the customer service. It's just I don't know. I feel really good about buying a SIM card now.
Touch it.
What?
Touch it.
Oh, it's
hot. How weird is that? They're
it's
warm.
Hot.
Like this is cold, and these ones are all warm. So like, I went to go get a juice, I'm like, what the heck?
That's crazy.
It's so weird.
So we've heard that Japanese like convenience stores, like 7-Eleven, Family Mart, those kinds of places, are just on a next level here in Japan. Right now we're just having a blast like grabbing some food and some drinks at the convenience store because I think we're gonna be doing this a lot in Japan because I think it's gonna be a good way for us to save a little bit of money.
And snacks. I love snacks.
Yeah.
I'm on an adventure already. I think I just wish I had more sleep to do all of this. Oh wow. It's sticky rice. Super sticky.
It's a cold chicken.
Oh my god.
You know, it really doesn't feel like we've gotten very far from the hotel. But we've got a few things done today.
Yeah.
Got swim SIM cards and now we've got second breakfast.
Next up, figuring out the train, huh? Cheers, I guess. This whole not speaking Japanese thing is very difficult.
So this is the part of the vlog where we try to figure out how to get to places using the metro station, or using the metro system in Japan. And if you didn't know, Japan has some of the most intricate metro networks in the entire world. But lucky for us, they're very efficient and should be, hopefully, very easy to learn.
Guidance will be displayed in English.
Metro's news. Speaker. So this is the card that we're going to use to use the metro system in Japan, like a lot in Tokyo, but also in other cities in Japan. And it's also can be used to like make payments at like convenience stores and stuff, like a card, like a credit card. This is awesome. I need two. To a lot of places, and I've used Google Maps and for multiple like cities public transportation, but I swear Japan and particularly Tokyo has the best like interface with Google Maps, so that you can really easily find out where you're going with Google Maps. It even tells you like, the platforms beyond, the time, like what kind of cars, how many like train cars there are on the train that you're on, and even gives you a live update of when the last departure was, like literally seconds ago. So I think that's pretty cool. So we have popped out of the train station now, and we're just walking. It's kind of a final few minutes walk to our hotel or hostel, and we've just like been plunked in this like really cute part of Japan or of Tokyo. I don't know how to describe it, but like the wooden railings here, right beside what could be a river, and then the what's it called, the trees.
I feel like I'm in a fairy tale.
Yeah, it does feel like
that. Yeah, it's like
look
a story.
Wow, like, what is all that?
This. Ah, yes, I see.
Don't know what it says, but it looks cool.
Wow, this is so beautiful.
You know, I really love seeing like natural green spaces like this, or like places where you can kind of get lost and forget that you're in a huge mega city. So I really appreciate that about Tokyo.
Leading this little tour so far.
So far, so good. I just wish I didn't have to bring my backpack with me. Okay, we're finally getting close to our hotel. So we are gonna wrap up our story and tell you guys a little bit about where we are headed. The family that we have here in Japan is quite far south.
They're the Kyushu region of Japan, which is ways away from Tokyo.
Yeah, so our hope is to like slowly make our way over there in the next few weeks. So of course we've got a little bit of time here in Tokyo to explore this massive city. And from here we go on our first ever bullet train.
Yeah, we're really pumped for that. The Shinkansen, I think it's gonna be so crazy.
Yeah, and that's gonna take us to Osaka.
And then after that, we're gonna explore the Osaka area, Kyoto, and Nara.
Mm-hmm. And then finally take a flight down to the Nagasaki area where our family is. So those are the plans for Japan.
And that actually takes us to our hotel, which is right there. So we're gonna leave you guys here. If you wanna see more of Japan and our adventures in Japan, make sure you hit subscribe. Yeah. If you like this video, give it a like. We guarantee you it's gonna be a fun time.
Thanks so much for watching, you guys.